My name is Leo Kouwenhoven. I'm the director here in Delft for the Microsoft Quantum Lab, where we develop a topological quantum computer. So quantum is a theory that describes how small particles behave. And small particles, I mean atoms. For instance, how atoms, two atoms, how they glue together and form a molecule. And the glue that keeps these two atoms together is, as far as we understand, only described by quantum theory. We don't have any other theory that describes how atoms behave. And the glue between atoms is actually very interesting and funny and counterintuitive. What happens in the glue is that we have two atoms and one extra electron. That extra electron could sit, for instance, on one atom or the other atom, but it doesn't. What it actually does, it sits on both atoms simultaneously at the same time. This is what we call a superposition. One atom, one electron that sits on two atoms at the same time. So there are many things in nature that we only understand because of this superposition. And this includes, why is grass green? We only understand colors because of those superpositions. Or photosynthesis, and that light in a green leaf is by some chemical process converted into, in the end, oxygen. It releases oxygen. These are quantum mechanical processes that makes use of superpositions in order for this light particle to be converted after some complicated process into an oxygen molecule. In a classical computer, we're actually not using these superpositions. We're encoding information in zeros and ones, but there's no such thing as encoding information in superpositions of zero and one. And with classical computers, we can do many things, but not those quantum things. The classical computer is a very ill machine, built machine, for solving quantum problems. So what is a quantum problem? Well, as I said, everything on Earth is glued together by superpositions. If we want to do something that helps us, you know, in using our natural resources more efficient, or curing our bodies from a disease, we're usually, you know, invoking some chemical process, like you slick a pill, or you take a pill. That pill does something chemical in your body, and you hope that you recover from your illness. Now, at the moment, we don't know how to compute these processes. We don't know how to predict or simulate processes in nature or in you know, biological systems. So we just try and see if it works or not. The method is try and error. If we would have a quantum computer in hand, then we can use it to help solving those problems at a very fundamental level. What is for a particular, let's say a battery, if you want to make a battery to save some energy, so how do we actually store energy at the level of atoms and molecules? And can we do that and retrieve all the energy out of the battery with 100% efficiency? There still are fundamental questions with respect to quantum computing. Nobody has ever made before a large-scale, controllable quantum system. And at the moment, we don't know what the quantum computer can do on a large scale. We know a certain set of problems where quantum computers will be revolutionary. Problems that are impossible to solve with classical computers will be solved on a quantum computer. But to predict what it can do on a large scale at this moment, that's too early still. We're still learning what all the applications of a quantum computer can be. We're at the very beginning of, let's say, we're in the 1980s for the internet. You know, who knows what the internet is going to bring us?